നമസ്കാരം. കരിയർ ഓസ്ട്രേലിയയുടെ മറ്റൊരു എപ്പിസോഡിലേക്ക് നിങ്ങൾക്കെല്ലാവർക്കും സ്വാഗതം. ഇന്ന് നമ്മുടെ കൂടെയുള്ളത് മിസ്റ്റർ ഗൗതം മനോഹരനാണ്. വെൽക്കം ഗൗതം.
ഹലോ
ടു ദ കരിയർ ഓസ്ട്രേലിയ പ്രോഗ്രാം. ഗൗതം, ബേസിക്കലി ഹി വർക്ക്സ് ആസ് ദ CTO, ചീഫ് ടെക്നോളജി ഓഫീസർ ഓഫ് മോഷൻ സൊല്യൂഷൻസ് ഓസ്ട്രേലിയ. And he works basically in the area of research and development in robotics, which basically works in the industries of mining, agriculture, pharmaceutical and defense. So welcome once again, Gautham, to
the show. Thank you for having me.
I think it's really interesting to talk about the future of work.
Sure.
You know, everybody is so excited about the future of work, and sometimes people are a bit uncertain about, you know, what's the future holds in terms of work and career opportunities.
Yep.
So do you like to tell us something about how does the future looks like?
Yep, sure. So right now, any market in overseas or even in India, so there is a lot of efficiency requirements because of shortage of labor. Mm-hmm. And labor costs are going really high.
Mm-hmm.
So people are more into like robotics, and industries are looking into robotics to mm-hmm. improve efficiencies and production in any field. Like usually it's manufacturing, that's what we see right now, we see the increasing everywhere else as well. Mm. Like hospital industry, like pharmacies, and everywhere. Yeah. Mm. Yeah.
Yep. So I think automation is something that is actually changing the landscape of every industry in the world at the moment, and it's actually creating a lot of opportunities and also changing the job, you know, jobs or careers, which you call you know, in the recent past, right?
That's correct. Yeah.
So I think one of those terms which I recently came across was about fourth industrial revolution.
Yep.
Which is basically talking about the technological advancements in the industries, and then how it's changing, you know, everything that the traditional way of doing business. Can you talk to us about something about the fourth industrial revolution?
Yep, sure. Yeah, yeah. So back then, the main focus on industrial revolution was to like take out manual labor mm. out of people
mm-hmm.
and then make it into a machine-oriented labor mm. So that the routine tasks which people do, it's all removed, and the machines do the routine tasks, and people work on better tasks like managing stuff and so the routine tasks were removed off the people and it was put into the robots
mm-hmm.
and after that they wanted to increase the efficiency of it. So electronics was inbuilt into it
mm.
and then came smarts. So there were intelligence into the machines, and the machine started like thinking by itself
mm.
and right now what's happening is, in the fourth industrial revolution, you are able to log in into the machine remotely from overseas. So usually the products developed in India go to, let's say, Germany, and in Germany it's working in a mining field, and in that mining field there's no one. Mm. It's just machines running everywhere
mm-hmm.
and let's say there's a breakdown, the machine ruptures or something.
Mm.
How do you fix that breakdown? So you can't send a person there and then identify what the breakdown is
mm.
and then send the parts again with a different set of technicians.
Yep.
And then fix it. It's not worth doing all that because mm-hmm. Cost-wise, it kills the company.
Mm.
So if you do it for every machine.
Yep.
So what people do is they are able to remotely log in with the advent of internet and so much technology improvement in the field of internet.
Mm.
So you are able to log in into the machine and identify what the problems are, and most of the problems you are able to fix it from overseas
mm-hmm.
and get the machine running again. And if it's a mechanical problem or an electrical problem where physical requirement is required, physical presence of a person is required,
mm-hmm.
then you know what parts to take with you.
Yep.
So it's not more like a guesswork. Mm-hmm. You know exactly what you need.
Yes.
So you just go there and fix that particular thing
mm.
and you come back. That's where fourth industrial revolution is taking you.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Yeah. Sounds exciting, you know. Yep. And it also sounds a lot of upcoming changes, or, you know, already changes are happening in some of the industries already, as you said, particularly in mining, or, you know, those industries were, you know, manual labor was so challenging.
Yeah,
right?
That's right.
Yeah. So coming back to robotics, you know, what were that really interested for you? You know, why you were interested in robotics and how you landed up, you know, started going to working in this space.
Oh yeah, sure. So from the childhood, I wanted to understand things which were happening around me. So I used to like break open a remote controlled car and connect it to power, not just DC power. Sometimes I've tried AC power and I've blown up the fuses and everything. But yeah, I've also tried like opening the telephones and fridges and everything just to understand what was happening. And as I grew up, I took it to the next level of understanding myself, like how do you operate like yourself, like how do you think, how do you like work, how did you know how to walk, all that. So when you work on the field of robotics, it teaches you all that, like how do people think, how do you know that you can grab something with your hand. Everything is robotics, like you learn so much. And opportunities wise, there is so much which opens up as soon as you learn robotics, because it doesn't just teach you robotics, it teaches you electrical stuff, mechanical stuff, software and mathematics, basically. Yeah, and that's where my focus was on. And so far I have no regrets. So
I think that's great. And I think, you know, that's like you are already into the future.
That's
you know?
Right.
That's very exciting for me. And, you know, in terms of when we talk about robotics, you know, I know there are a lot of happenings in terms of what's coming to the future. But as you were saying earlier, it's also into some of the industries already.
Correct.
Right. So can you tell us about which industries are already, you know, leading ahead in terms of working in the space of robotics?
Yep, sure. So from the start of Industrial Revolution in 1850s, there has been robotics in manufacturing, not just physical like part manufacturing as a mechanical company, but even in food and beverage, mainly in food and beverage, that's where we see. And after that, there has been robotics in research, and then they took it to mining, railways. So right now we are seeing automated cars coming up.
Yep.
So that's also a part of automation and robotics. So mainly like they're trying to avoid people, like people are really powerful. Even though they don't understand that they're really powerful, people, they can think, and that's what robots can't do. And it's a trivial job where you do manual labor and driving every day, like truck drivers and bus drivers. All those jobs, they're routine jobs which has been happening right now. We could put them in a better role, and they could manage industries, transport industries and stuff, and you have the routine work of driving given to a robot. And the same thing has been happening in manufacturing as well, which is already transformed manufacturing. Before, we've seen companies where in the 1980s they were about 1,000 staff employed just to pack chocolates. And right now, if you look at it, there are only like 20 people. And the amount of chocolates produced back then were about 1,000 chocolates a day. But right now, if you have a look, there are 1,000 chocolates a minute, which is being produced by robots.
Yeah, that's massive.
And it's being packed. Yeah, that's right. So there are entire plants which have only robots in them. Like, I don't know whether you've heard about Tesla cars.
Yes, I've heard of them.
Yeah. So the whole plant is just robots. And the reason is because all this transformation is to improve efficiency, reduce labor being involved in routine jobs, and also to get more money by the industries. Like it makes more money because of reducing labor. That's, and especially overseas. Because there's shortage of labor and people overseas, they have to go this way. It's not just cost, but to improve more, get more production, they have to go to machines, and that helps them get more money, and it drives the whole economy in the end.
So that sounds really, you know, good for the businesses. Because, you know, when you're talking about 1,000 chocolates from a day to amenities, that's, I think, a big process improvement.
That's right.
That can really change the way industries are at the moment.
Correct. And the labor also has decreased from 1,000 to 20.
Wow.
So, there's so much transformation being involved inside every business nowadays.
So that's actually a good example of, you know, how robotics is making differences in you know, in the ground level of an organization, you know. It's that's the basic level. And I think sometimes people, you know, the in the past industrial revolutions, and it's more about machines, or it's more about, you know, repetitive task. And now this is more about, you know, people can do interesting, much more interesting jobs, and then leave the repetitive tasks for, you know, robots.
Yeah. That's correct.
That's exactly. Good to know.
Yeah.
So now, you know, when we talk about this, you know, one of the people, or, you know, one of the set of people who are interested in learning more about this is children, you know, because they are the next generation, and they will have a lot of interest in what they should know, and, you know, what they should look at now if they are really interested in learning robotics. So, you know, what is your opinion? Why children should be interested in knowing robotics?
So why children should be interested in knowing robotics would be, I would give my own example as what is the motivating factor. So usually for anyone, the motivating factor are three things. One is learning. People like to learn new stuff. The other is in order to help other people. There should be a purpose for what you do. And the third thing is money, like stomach or money. You need to fill your stomach. So all these things are achieved by robotics way more than, that's what I feel, in my opinion. It's achieved by robotics more than any other field. It's because you learn not just what's happening outside, but you learn how you operate and how other people interact with each other. So there's also robots which talk to each other while they're operating. And based on their communication, they operate according to what the other robot requires or how the previous robot has sent you something. And all this is basically what we communicate. And we take it for granted. And we don't really give some emphasis on what we do in our daily lives. And how... we do all these is really amazing, and it's so inspiring, and it motivates. This has to be what should be taught to a child. Like as soon as a child is born, we can't teach a robot how to stand up. And the most challenging part right now is when a robot falls down with limbs and stuff. If it falls down, it's so hard to get it back up. And because it's that hard. But if you look at a child, as soon as it falls down, it knows how to get back up, and nobody taught it how to get back up. So it learns by itself. So all these little things which we take for granted, it's so hard to replicate it. And once you have all this replicated, there's so much going on around the world which you can improve in terms of efficiency and growth and everything. In order to motivate children, you have to improve their curiosity levels from the childhood. Like you have to ask them to ask why. Why do you have to have something to eat every day? Nobody knows. Parents feed their baby, and the baby doesn't know why he has to eat in the end. And how much you have to eat. All that is mathematics in the end. What fills you? What's enough? All that. So as curiosity leads to a point, it motivates the baby to learn mathematics more and more. And because everything comes to mathematics in the end. And that's what I feel. That leads
to robotics. So it's more of that creating those curiosity, and, you know,
that's great.
Having that interest in maths or, you know, similar areas to start with. So, you know, with said that, you know, what do you think in terms of the current global opportunities available for people who are interested in, you know, having a career in robotics?
So Singapore right now, the government itself is funding all the engineers in Singapore to get into robotics. So the reason is because it creates a lot of job opportunities, not just locally but internationally, for the people in Singapore. So they have so many courses which teach you robotics and stuff. It's not just, you don't have to be focused on robotics itself, but electrical engineering, mechanical engineering, software engineering, anything would help robotics to improve in its field. Mm. So basically all these roles wouldn't die because of robotics. So as robotics improves and after 50 years, if you have a look at it, you already there is so much research which has been happening for people to go into other planets and develop other planets and stuff. Yep. Because if you think about the long-term future of robotics, it will be set up such that Earth will be a residential zone and other planets will be industrial zones. Wow. And because of the amount of human population growing, so it won't be sustainable to have both industrial and a pure residential zone in the same planet. Mm. So what happens is, in order to have more production, you'd send robots to other planets where you can't really live. Mm. People can't survive there.
Yep.
So you send robots there, they mine, they build their own buildings and industrial zones, mm-hmm. and they produce, manufacture products, and they send it over here. So this will be a long-term future. Yeah. So this is where it will get to, because right now, because of the advent of medicine and so much research going on in medicine, mm-hmm. Number of generations who are living right now has increased from 2 to 3 and to 4.
Yep. The lifespan is increasing.
Because of lifespan being increased, the number of generations in a house is increased to 4. Like in many places, I see 5 generations living in the same house.
Yes.
So as this happens and the lifespan increases, Earth cannot accommodate both industries which produce stuff for the people in the planet. Mm. So you need to have industrial zones set up outside and get products sent here.
That's a lot of new information for me. You know,
I
never knew that the people are, you know, who are working in robotics are planning to send robots to other planets.
It's really far-fetched, but it will happen in 50 years.
That's where it's going. So you know, with all these changes you're talking about, sometimes there are so many other side of the story where it says robotics, whether it's a threat to mankind or is it going to change the job opportunities where people are having now. So what do you think, is that a true statement?
No, I would definitely not agree with that. Mm. It's because people get more time to spend with their children right now compared to 20 years back. Mm. What's happening is the job roles change and the amount of time people work in the industry reduces. Because of this, you get more time to spend with your family and less stress and all that. It's mainly the routine work, which I was saying before, mm-hmm. Which is being pulled out of people and put into the robots. So right now people might be doing data entry and like filling Excel sheets and all that. So a robot can do all that. And you will be interested more in like how to manage those data and data science. And there are new fields like data science, which has emerged recently. This didn't exist 10 years back. So the reason is because of robotics and automation.
Mm.
It's more like the market is changing towards people doing better things than just spending time in the office doing routine work and not really purposeful as from a people's perspective.
So in terms of you did mention earlier about children's developing curiosity for children in terms of the having that interest in robotics. So someone from a children's perspective, if what they should learn in terms of if they wanted to have a future career, what are those skills or attributes they should start developing now, which will actually help them to enhance their knowledge in this area and develop that skill set, which will be good for them when they look for a future in robotics career or something like that?
Mm. I would say you have to nurture the human quality of curiosity. That's the main thing. Mm. It's not something new for mankind. It's what was already in there and what makes us different to animals. So it's mainly you have to start getting the children to think and what's happening around, you have to teach them and get them to ask questions like why and how, and that really promotes them to understand what's happening and what motivates them to learn different aspects like physics, maths, chemistry. So it's like if you sow a seed, not all seeds grow at the same time. Like some seeds take some time to grow and the other seeds are they grow faster.
Yeah.
But in the end, they have to grow. That's the key.
Yep.
So you can't say one's not growing faster, so I'll just disregard it, ignore it, and then I'll just keep feeding the one which is growing faster. That's not the way it works. Like even in the end, everything has to grow and everything together is what promotes mankind. Like, it's togetherness and networking and all that.
Yep.
And with all this, you have to get the children to ask these questions. Why is like the most important question anyone has invented? And once they start thinking in those lines, they start understanding things, what's happening around them, inside them, everything. And it gives them knowledge to improve what's happening around. And then once they get that knowledge, they start sharing it with mankind and they improve the total quality of life everywhere and things happen. And they're not just regular things, it's amazing things which happen.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I think that's really a good thing, you know, to talk about, because this is not about advancing yourself, but it's basically going back to the basics and, you know, develop those qualities which and then, you know, develop from then there from that. Basics.
That's correct.
So you know, the one last thing I would like to ask you is about the future of robotics, and then, you know, in terms of sustainability, how sustainable it is, you know, what is your opinion on that?
So if you look at the future after 30 years, I would say there will be three industries which will be performing well compared to other industries. One would be entertainment. People like to laugh, have a like go out and see something, and they like stories from their childhood, and they like to see stories, and that's why movies are performing well. And biotechnology and development in biomedicine. So this is to improve health and healthcare, and people like to be they like to know that someone is actually helping them to like live longer and happier. And the third thing would be robotics. It's because like I said, as you pull out routine stuff out of people, they start thinking in other terms, and they do something bigger than just going somewhere, filling 10 hours of work and then coming back home.
So once
they do something bigger, it actually improves everything. Like like I was saying before, quality of life, the amount of hours they spend at home, and it, as a far-fetched thing, people can't just depend on just one planet. So they have to go to other planets, and once they go to other planets, they'll be indestructible. Right now we are still destructible, because once something hits our planet, that's it, we are done. And and once you have to come across that, you will have to go to other planets, other galaxies, and all this is possible only if you send robots to other planets and test those planets, and then you know exactly what you have there, and make it suitable for you to live there. So this is like a far-fetched, maybe 300-year thing, but that's where it will go to.
That's like the future.
And that empowers mankind, and people will, once you know all this, people won't fight for like regular things in there.
It primarily enhances the quality of life, and I think that's a great thing for mankind. You know, this is really going to be a big difference in how we live and work. I think future of work is more than exciting than ever, and we are really looking forward to it. Thank you so much, Gautham, for being here today and giving us a good piece of advice and a lot of information about what future unfolds. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
See you soon. Bye.